Hey guys, the Ape Monkey with another snapshot review. This is right, we've just had a snapshot out and there's another one. This is 14W26C. It's to fix a lot of bugs, including a major issue with the last A and B snapshots, which was chunk errors. Lots and lots of chunk errors. So if you have a world that you generated or you opened in 26A and 26B, do not, I repeat, do not open it in C until you've checked my previous video. There might be a fix. There's a link in the description of that video, and it might fix it. If not, you may have lost your worlds forever, unfortunately. That's why I always say, back up your blummin' worlds, okay? Your blummin' worlds need backing up, so blummin' back them up. That's my new phrase. Anyway, so in 14W26C, Surge has added the following awesome command. So if I stand here and I press this little button here, I will get Blockhead. I have blocks going on my head. Now, this is so freaking cool. This basically allows you to put blocks on your head slot. Now, previously, in the last snapshot, I showed you that you could do your armor or anything like that, but it only worked with specific items, items that were allowed to be used. Not anymore. Now you can use blocks as well. Unfortunately, you can't use items, but you can use blocks. And just look at this thing. It cycles through them. So cool, and I love it. So you could, if you were having, like, say, a block hunt game, you could have the person's head be the block that they are, and it'd be all cool and stuff like that, or mini games or anything that requires you to have a block on your head. Now, I'm sure there's loads of ideas out there. I could just go into the ground and pretend I'm a block. It's like, yep, I'm a block. Ignore me. Just a plain old block here. I'm just a block. Totally ignore me. But yeah, this is so cool. So as you can see, it is just cycling through all these command blocks here, which have a different command in them. So let's check what one of these commands are. So here we've got the same as the other commands I showed you in the last one. So you've got replace item at the entity, which is me, at all players. The slot armor head, Minecraft, gold block. That's it. It's as simple as that. And that will put a gold block on my head. If I changed it to, say, a diamond block, there's a diamond block. There's a stone brick. That one's sandstone. That one's stone. And there's loads of these that go all the way down. And then that's a little bit that cycles just back around again. And it's just so cool. I absolutely love it. Now, obviously, you can move them out your head like that as well. You can take them out, which might be a limitation when it comes to maybe doing on a server or a sort of a mini game. If you don't want the people actually getting the blocks, there might be some sort of way of stopping them from doing that. But as of right now, I don't know what the idea would be. But you can just destroy it all. And there it goes. I'm just going to keep take this off because otherwise I'll keep getting blocks on my head for a repeated amount of time, and I need my head for something else. Okay, there we go. Okay, so something that Serge showed in a snapshot, like preview sort of thing, was this. This is a ambulance villager. Nina, 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 Nina. Hello, what, I need some help.
Yep, what do you need?
I need to go to the hospital.
Water, there is water over there.
Thank you. So yeah, basically, this is just a cycle that's going through from this one, which is targeting the closest villager, C1 right there, and it's got a slot of armor head, and then it's giving them a Minecraft stained glass, one stained glass, and damage value of 14, which is red, I believe. And then this one is 11, which is blue, I believe. But either way, it's red and blue on each one of those, and a little clock, and it's doing that, which is really nice. Now, another thing you can do is give them player heads. So if you're wanting to play with Sarge inside the game, or Surge even inside the game, you can do that! And there you go. You got a Surge inside your game. It's a little bit strange. Looks a little bit funky. But heck, that's what it looks like, I guess. Unless you want me, then you can do that. You can have me in the game with a little goatee. Once again, looks really, really kind of bizarre. Or if you want like a little Bobby version, then there you go. There's a little mini monkey. Mini monkey for the win. But yeah, this is basically all the commands that you need to do for them. So you got replace item entity at entity, which is the type villager, and it's the closest one again, then slot head armor skull 1-3, which is the player head, and then skull owner, which is Surge, or the skull owner, which is me, or the ape monkey. Or you can change, of course, to someone else as much as you want. So you could do a notch, for instance, or you can have a notch like that, and then of course, when you click the button, it'll give notch. It'll also give me a little bit of lag, but there's notch. That's just head right there. Or you can have a little baby dinner bone, maybe. Let's see if I can get no, I'll do a notch again, because I'm not sure what dinner bone's name is. I think it's dinner bone, but I think it might be like underscores in there somewhere. But anyway, there's mini notch. Diddy notch. Anyway, so that's really cool. That is so cool. Now, another cool thing you can do with this, obviously, is give yourself a nice little block on your head. Now, maybe you're wanting to do some sort of diving adventure. Well, there you go. I have now got, not that button, I have now got a scuba outfit, I guess. So I can go into the water now and swim around and have respiration. Because this helmet here has got respiration 4, 5 even. Restoration 3 and Aqua Affinity 5, which is definitely enough to keep me alive under the water. So if I go into game mode, survival, there we go. I can see underwater, I can walk around underwater, and my air is going to stay quite high for the time being because of the Aqua Affinity and whatnot. It's really cool. Oh, the respiration, I should say. It's really cool. So you could basically make a dive suit for an adventure map with people having glass on their head, which would look really, really cool and quite legitimate to a diving outfit, which I really, really like. So thank you to that idea, because that was from a suggestion on Reddit, I believe, or it might have been a suggestion on my Twitter, one of the two. But yeah, really cool, and I love it a lot. So that I'm very happy with. Now, not only can you give yourself blocks, you can also give yourself some sort of, well, they are blocks, they're technically blocks, but they don't always seem like blocks. But yes, you can give yourself things like a anvil, and give yourself a little mohawk, and pity the fool, like Mr. T. I pity the fool. I say I pity the fool. Which is kind of fun, kind of weird, but fun. Or you can give yourself some horns, and you can be a bull using a fence post, or a fence gate, sorry. So you can give yourself some horns and be a horny. Or you can give yourself, I got something stuck in my head, I think it's a ladder, oh crap, it's in my head, help me. Or you can give yourself just a nice, very smiley face, and there you can be a dropper as well. And these are all really cool and fantastic additions to the game. Now you could set yourself up with some sort of maybe snowballs that come out your mouth. Let's see if we can do this. This will look kind of cool, actually. Give yourself some snowballs, like this. And then if I put myself into first, like that. And I put my mouth like that, and then do this. Blah, la, 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 la. That looks really cool. I like that. That is so cool. I'm just spewing up snowballs from the dispenser. That is, I love it. Maybe you could do some sort of command block system where you're fighting each other with arrows that come out of players' mouths. You can have like them summoned from the player's mouth or the player's head location from dispensers or droppers. It looks so cool. So imagine that this is going to open up a lot of options for people who are making maps or mini games or anything like that, really. I really like it. It's a fantastic addition. We weren't sure if it was going to be added in the previous snapshot because obviously you could have helmets and whatnot, but we didn't try blocks, they wouldn't work. Obviously you can't do items, but you can definitely do blocks. I think ladders might be the exception to the rule, although they are a block, they seem like an item, it's very iffy ground. But nevertheless, go ahead and play with all these and have a try and see which one you think works best. Because, that's not my name, the options are endless really when it comes to this. The ideas out there for you guys are insane. I mean, you guys have amazing ideas. And I'm sure all you guys out there will come up with some fantastic things to use with all this, with these effects and all of these features. So, hope you enjoyed it, guys. If you did, be sure to like, share, comment, subscribe. And until next time, TTYL, peace out and bye-bye. Toodles! I'm just gonna spew up some snowballs. There you go. Ah! I freaking love it. Bye, guys. Oh, wow, this is awesome.